For Smaragda in the warehouse. She's waiting.
What does it mean to be truly righteous? To never succumb to temptation, or to take a vow of chastity despite constant temptation? Our heroine did not know the answer to this question and preferred never to dwell on it. If it were up to her, she would have chosen the quiet life of a nun. However, destiny had something different in store for her.
For the sake of the prayers of odyssey. Stesha, do you have something prepared for Smaragda? It's cold today, isn't it? Oh, potato. Thank you. Thank you.
The sisters loved Indika. Christian love is known to be patient, merciful, and faithful. However, in a lowly human sense, They didn't love her that much. To be completely honest, they didn't love her at all. Many of them felt nothing but disgust for her. Indika, however, was not to blame. Were it not for the voice that was inculcating ideals in her, unforgivable for a Christian, she would have been a virtuous and rather mediocre nun. Indika's biggest dream was for that voice to leave her alone once and for all. Her entire life became a struggle, a painful resistance. No matter how hard she tried, no matter how much she tortured herself, the voice grew louder and more convincing every day.
Thank you.
Useless labor is the basis of spiritual development. Obedience is above fasting or prayers. Indika didn't understand why she needed to retrieve the water from the well if there was a pump next door that took it from a sacred spring. She didn't understand why drinking from the spring was allowed, but cooking soup was a sin. The well was only about 15 meters away from the spring. It was not possible to have any other water there. Even a tenth of it is the same. They say, on Epiphany, even a drop of holy water blesses an entire canister. If that were true, a couple of evaporated drops from the spring would bless the puddles beneath her.
We haven't eaten even 10 of them. With God's help, we'll make it to spring. No way. Sisters won't eat after her.
Mother, the sign of the cross saves from the plague. But this, God forgive me.
Lord, Smaragda, don't tempt me. I'm sending Evdokia to you. Don't let this one into the refectory.
Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May my communion of thy immaculate mysteries, O Lord, not be judged or condemned, but healed of body and soul.
It is forbidden to leave the convent without a blessing. Despite her requests, Indika had not been blessed to leave for a full year. When she was tasked with delivering the letter, it took her completely by surprise. Even though she did not know the contents of that letter, she could not shake the feeling that it would play an extremely important, perhaps critical, role.
What's in it?
the sake of the prayers of all the saints, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us. Tisha, I need to go to the other side. Georgie, pirate, be quiet.
The animals feel the unholiness.
They're just happy to see me. Tisha, I'm sorry.
The animals feel the unholiness.
I brought you some apples. Or lovka, your favorite. Tisha, I must hurry to the train. Are all wet. Slip and fall again. Don't worry, Tichon. I understand. Forgive me, for Christ's sake. The key. Oh, what an imbecile.
Indika loved Tichon. Imbecile was a medical diagnosis, so she was just using the word literally. In any case, Tichon couldn't hear her. Hypocrisy isn't really a virtue, is it? It was as if the convent didn't want to let her go. Even though she knew there was no place closer to God, she yearned to leave it, at least for a short time.
Not true!
I think deep...
The Almighty Wisdom has had compassion on our souls here in these latter days, as they need us in need by their bloodshedding. Wounded, so have I also fallen through my sins, and my soul is wounded. To whom shall I flee for healing, if not to thee, the compassionate Samaritan? Pour on me, O Christ, thy great mercy. As a disciple of the Lord, O just one, thou hast received the gospel as a martyr. Thou art never turned away as the brother of God. Thou hast boldness as a hierarch. Thou canst intercede. Do thou intercede with Christ God that he may save our souls. O ineffable and unseen grace, for who can tell of thy mighty works? O Christ, who can number the multitude of thy wonders? I have recklessly forgotten my glory, O Father, and among sinners I have scattered the riches which thou gavest me. As of old thou didst raise up the paralytic, O Lord God, by thy godlike care and might raise up my soul, which is palsied by diverse sins and transgressions, and by unseemly deeds and acts. But saved only cry out, give me to thy power, O compassionate Christ. And how I cry to thee as the prodigal I have sinned before thee, O merciful Father, receive me repentant and make me as one of thy hired servants, because of that done.
Pretending to be interested in the lives of the saints, apologizing, repenting, praying, apologizing, endless oaths, the black veils, apologizing, crying, apologizing, apologizing. Old women, and even
thou didst raise up the paralytic.
If the abbess was literate, she surely didn't go out of her way to use that skill. Just like her personal hygiene, always at lunch, she would carefully clean the devil's work from her dentures with her finger. Indika hated endless prayers that were repeated so much they lost their original meaning. Hated to smile at Sister Martha's toothless jokes. Hated the fuming candles, the rotting potatoes, the never.
Like the man who fell among thieves and was wounded, so have I also fallen through my sins, and my soul is wounded. To whom shall I flee for healing, if not to thee, the compassionate Samaritan? Pour on me, O Christ, thy great mercy. Because of thy boundless mercy and compassion, I dare to approach thee, O Christ. Receive me as thou didst the publican, the God in the heart. I have recklessly forgotten my glory, O Father.
In the lives of the saints, apologizing, repenting, praying, apologizing, endless oaths, the black veils, apologizing, crying, apologizing, apologizing, apologizing.
Most of the wisdom has had compassion on our souls, who in this latter days has been with us in need by their bloodshedding. As a disciple.
Half of the sisters couldn't even read. Even if the abbess was literate, she surely didn't go out of her way to use that skill.
When this man of good deeds, but I beseech thee, O Lord, that he may drop it from us and cleanse me, for I am defiled by it.
Indika hated endless prayers that were repeated so much they lost their original meaning. Hated to smile at Sister Martha's toothless jokes. Hated the fuming
the Lord, O just one, thou hast received the gospel as a martyr. Thou art never turned away as the brother of God. Thou hast boldness as a hierarch. Thou canst intercede. Do thou intercede with Christ God that he may save our souls. Like the man who fell among thieves and was wounded, so have I also fallen through my sins and received those wounded. To whom shall I flee for healing, if not to thee, the compassionate Samaritan? Pour on me, O Christ, thy great mercy. For as thou in thy deep wisdom hast had compassion on our souls during these latter days, as thou may be.
Fasting, apologizing, pretending to be interested in the lives of the saints, apologizing, repenting, praying, apologizing, endless oaths, the black veils, apologizing.
Mercy and grace, for who can tell of thy mighty works? O Christ, who can remember the multitude of thy wonders? I have recklessly forgotten my glory, O Father, and the incense I have
sacrificed. Old women that even incense could not cover. Half of the sisters couldn't even read. Even if the abbess was literate, she surely didn't go out of her way to use that skill. Just like her personal hygiene, always at lunch, she would carefully clean the...
And how I cry to thee as the prodigal I have sinned before thee, O merciful Father, receive me repentant and make me as one of thy hired servants. As of old, thou didst raise up the paralytic, O Lord God, by thy godlike care and might, raise up my soul, which is palsied.
What are you doing here? You. The cloisters is here! What
nun is fine.
The conventual is here!
The nun.
Listen, you're lucky to bump into me. I can be missing and I'm not good at this.
What?
Go. Get out of here. What? Who's there?
To bump into him. He's
not a great shot.
Yes.
Sorry, I can help if you let me.
I don't think it can be helped. His nobleness has decided to listen to the visitation one last time. So let him listen. Don't interrupt.
Excuse me, what happened here?
Have you heard the joke about a crowbar and a train toilet? So, there was this train with a bunch of convicts. They put a spring between two carriages while the train was moving. Tried to plan an escape, I guess.
How many died?
Mostly fugitives. Many of them were shot. Have I had to care for the sick?
Me? Of course. We often have to.
Then come with us to the station. All the wounded are there. Go!
Of respect for his dying wish, or for the size of his epaulets. What do you think?
Husband?
Husband?
I guess he was loved.
No.
Thank you.
Since when do you remain near? Horror. Fear is a natural reaction, life-saving in most cases. What is your goal? To help the girl or show what a hero you are? Exactly. If you're trying to help, there's no chance. Listen to her. Doesn't like getting abandoned in the middle of an act. What? Did you see the size of that thing?
Not bad either.
I didn't have enough, you motherfucker. Let's back at it again.
I've saved someone too. Oh God, little Morn, she could have. You didn't see. She got away. Well, I did. I don't know how much, but if it weren't for me, I'd never see her. Sorry. What is your name?
Ilya.
Indika. You know they say that every hour that a patient doesn't get medical attention, their chance of survival is halved. Crazy thing to say, to be honest. It makes no sense to generalize like that. Do we include every case, even a pricked finger? Of course, the doc...
No idea where to take it or where it came from.
Sister! You arrived safely. No incident. Cassio, is that you? Wait a second!
Hey, you drop your weapon. Drop it!
You drop your weapon! Throw your rifle in. Don't turn your conscience with sin.
You're going nowhere, mate. Alright? Manage.
I've got nothing to lose.
Fine. Don't shoot.
All right.
Do it like this.
Get on. Get on him. I'm telling you, go. Go. Get on. Get going! Get going! I'm telling you!
But I won't fight him, huh? Yeah. Come on in! Yeah. Move it, Derek!
just come back!
Eyes on the road.
I've had enough to stop!
Why are you aiming your revolver at me?
Wait!
You won't shoot me.
Please!
Why is that? If you don't go faster, I will.
Only go stop where you are! Right now!
Wait.
Just wait!
Not so fast.
I will shoot! You bitch! You fucking bitch! Scoundrel!
Hey. Are you wounded? This is good.
No.
Say. Get up. No, 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 you don't need that. Let's go.
Wait, what on this?
Well, either with me or with them, up to you.
So much.
Sorry. We're doing no more than 5 verses an hour, though.
Oh, yeah. How do you understand it, huh?
Is he talking about the word versed or how to start an engine?
I grew up in a bike shop. My father sold them.
In Spasov?
Why in Spasov? No, in Gorodishchi. Never been to Spasov.
That's where I grew up.
The man's logic is flawless.
Are you embarrassed to be so close to a man?
She's been waiting for that. He's quite a looker, huh? Thick boy.
I must smell awful. Well, they kept us on the train for 3 days.
Oh, don't worry. She likes it.
Oh! Pardon.
Come on! Grab her tits.
Hey!
Stop pretending. He's just like the men you imagine in your room when you're...
Enough!
All right, calm down.
Is he a bandit or a sissy?
Hold on to your seat, for God's sake.
Thank you.
Take a look, please.
There's nothing to look at. Would it give me an injection?
Oh, my God. I'm afraid this will happen. If we don't amputate it, you won't survive the afternoon.
Our prison doctor, he told me the same thing. Word for word. But that was over a week ago.
And he didn't do anything?
Sadly, the only surgical equipment was a rusty wash basin.
Very funny.
All right. Don't worry. It should be like that. Only like that. And I'm also talking to God.
To God? Great. You need to get up if you don't want to lose something else to frostbite.
What do you mean you talk to God?
What? Oh, my arm. You've seen my arm, yes? It's been a week or more.
I doubt it. And what does God have to do with this?
Well, let me explain. Ever since that night, everything, every event, it all happened as I was told it would. I'm certain I was the only one who left that train alive. It's all going according to plan. Every fucking step is God's plan, do you understand?
So taking me hostage was God's plan?
I know what you're thinking. But remember the gospel. The father who gave his money to the prodigal son, not to the beloved one, the good one, but to the bandit. He who'd been murdering and stealing but came back. He came back. Do you understand? I think the Lord is happier to see one repentant sinner than 100,000 righteous people. I don't know. They don't even need repentance. Do you hear me? You know, he laid everything out before me. Spread out like a deck of cards. The past, the present, the future.
Who?
God, who else? I was lying there, about to die. And a sister, just like you, brought me some water in this mug. And I was drinking and I saw ripples in the water. Little round waves. And heard a whisper. So I drank. And...
You heard God in a cup?
In a cup, yes. But that's not the point. I'll show you when we get there. Maybe we should go around.
A nun and an officer? Who cares?
For the telegraph poles. The cable's ripped out, though.
And the road. Doesn't look like it's been used lately.
The fuck would do this? It's as if they blocked the passage on purpose.
The brake is rusted shut. I have to find something to get rid of the screw.
It won't fucking budge.
Something in that shed.
Thank you.
So,